The next honoree is Leopoldo Di Yao. He's accompanied today by his wife, Bella. His citation reads, in recognition of outstanding technical innovations in manufacturing processes for the production of DRAMs, dynamic random access memories, and microprocessors. Dr. Yao is a retired Intel Fellow and Director of Innovation Technology Modules at Intel Corporation in Hillsboro, Oregon. He earned his doctoral degree in electrical engineering at Illinois and then taught at the University of the Philippines and also at Illinois before joining the Bell Laboratories Group in 1973. This was one of the first to realize the relentless reduction in the size of the metal oxide semiconductor MOS transistors profoundly affects the physics of the transistor and its electrical characteristics. He conceived and published what became known as the Yao model, a theory that predicts the threshold of short channel MOS transistors with remarkable accuracy. Today, computer-aided design circuit simulation tools, such as those used in Intel, have incorporated the Yao model. And I can say personally that Professor Oldham's class in Berkeley, that was my first homework in EE231. I remember this today. His innovations in lithography and dielectrics for transistors were critical to the process, to the success of Intel's DRAM products and were subsequently extended to Intel Logix chips, including the 66 megahertz Pentium that revolutionized computer systems. Dr. Yao is the inventor of the plastic passivation technology for DRAMs and was the first to introduce dual-frequency plasma-enhanced chemical vapor deposition to the deposition of intermetallic dielectrics. Strongly committed to excellence in education at Illinois, Dr. Yao has worked with faculty and students and assisted with corporate donations, such as an award of state-of-the-art integrated circuit fabrication equipment to the Integrated Circuit Fabrication Laboratory in the ECE department. I'm honored today to present the final College of Engineering Alumni Distinguished Service Award to Leopoldo Di Yao.
Well, Adi, thank you for nominating me for this award, and also Andreas. And I'm really humbled by this award. This university is quite unique. And this morning, Milton and Jerry Marsick and I were listening to one of your iconic figures by the name of Nick Holonyak. He reminded us that it was the invention of the transistor, one of the inventor, John Bardeen, who is also was, actually a professor of this university, that made our life today so different. In fact, you guys would not be here today without the invention of that transistor. Bardeen actually was here before I came in the 50s, and he hired two iconic figures in the industry. One was Nick Holonyak, who is still here, and the other person was my advisor, C.T. Shah. He went to the University of Florida. And my future really was molded by C.T. Shah academically, but socially, it was Nick Holonyak that provided us a lot of friendship and social activity. My personal advisor, C.T. Shah, was too serious for any social activity. And many of his students know that. But, you know, not many people still realize that, you know, coming here to University of Illinois, having this, the influence of these figures, Bardeen, Shah, and Nick Holonyak, has transformed many of our students' lives. And Nick Holonyak correctly reminded me and Marsick today that, you know, you guys will not be here if not for the invention of the transistor. And it's really, really what changed a lot of our lives today. And the other thing that things were so, what you call, interesting when, for us, doing all this lab work here, staying here late night, and even taking all that, what you call, discipline and training that we got from the university working on a PhD, we got that same discipline working at Bell Labs, at Intel, and, you know, it's so interesting that many of us would even miss dinner, and some of us would not even take a weekend off. And the unfortunate thing is that we have to have a wife that is very tolerant of all of that. So I'm so thankful that my wife is Bell right here, was so tolerant for all of us. Well, anyway, thank you, University of Illinois, for all these doors that you opened for my life. It's really would not have been possible without the discipline and training we got from the University of Illinois. Thank you. Thank you.